not them.
Yeah, so Shakira is a kind person, full of love.
Okay.
I have a tagline that says "Shucks with love." I believe love is the answer, and I believe God is love. So I represent God in a way of love,
okay.
And I want to just share my gift with people with a purpose, of course.
Okay.
If I've danced for 23 years, it means it hasn't been easy, of course.
That was my next question. You see, we are in the Women's Month.
Oh my
Tomorrow
goodness.
Is going to be Women's Day.
Yes.
And as women, we have evolved so much.
Yes.
All right, let's look here.
Oh, sorry. Oh my goodness. Yes,
so
yes.
We've evolved so much.
Yeah.
In entertainment, to be specific, because,
yes,
you know, this is the sector we are in right now.
Uh-huh.
But musically, the artists who sing,
mm-hmm,
then we have the dancers,
mm-hmm,
whose platform was limited.
Talk about it.
Was limited, really, really limited. Okay. They had all these challenges. But now we are here, as, mm-hmm, you speak, 23 years,
mm-hmm,
so much has happened.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to take us through that journey,
okay,
how it was then.
Then and now.
Yes.
I'm blessed to be able to have both experiences.
Exactly, true.
So when it started, of course, we didn't have social media. We didn't have the platform to be able to show our talent and showcase.
So how would you get to how would an artist get to you?
And even before that, the way you said, dance was not respected then. Still, there's some people who respect it, but it's really not really respected. But we're going to change that.
We will.
Yeah. So when we started, we had challenges like, how do you get work? How would an artist or any brand, let's say brands that give us work, to be able to get us?
Okay.
But when we started, we had an MD called Julius Chazé.
Now yes,
the founder of Swans,
yes,
and Buzz. So he was really, really sharp, and he had his ways of how to search for work, and he managed to come in contact with Sylvia Worry,
okay,
who gave us the first performance. It was first gig in Lira, I remember.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not so sure about the years because I was very young.
No.
I was very young, and for them, they're a bit older.
Yeah.
So that's how we managed to get our first opportunity. From clubs, of course, when we started, we were in Mukono. We were doing stuff in Mukono. Then we came all the way to Kampala, where we managed to get networking with Sylvia Worry. And we got a gig. From that gig, it was a rebirth of different other gigs. You get. So that's how we managed. It was a talk of mouth. Oh, did you work with Eclipse? I want to work Obsession. What about Eclipse?
Oh,
I
want to work
Obsession. That's how
in how many were you in Eclipse?
We were 12. We were 6 girls,
okay,
and 6 boys.
Oh, okay.
So at that time, of course, we were doing dance, drama, and acting, skits, and it was everything, music, dance, and drama. And through those experiences, we managed to get international gigs that whenever artists used to come in, we used to be only 2 dance groups that were respected and were valued,
yes,
and we were, they were proud of us. So everybody was like, Obsession, Eclipse.
Yes.
So during that time, of course, we managed to get work. And just fast forward to this generation, this era, where we have social media. Social media has been very, very helpful.
True,
I would say from having the connection of the Ugandan market, we managed to go and change the world in Kenya. That's where I am now.
Yes.
Eclipse went to Kenya and changed the world because they were doing acrobats.
Okay.
So when we went there, we surveyed and managed to see they didn't have something that we had. We went there and took over. They respected us, they loved us until today, and they supported us. And through going to Nairobi, that's how my MD managed to be able to go to different streams of income and get people to come and come on board.
Okay.
And is that something I've not replied? And,
yes, I needed to know the then and now, because you see, when
challenges.
You talk, I need to know,
challenges.
Because I need you to pinpoint something that happened when you had started coming, that shaped you to be the person that you are right now.
Yes, being females or being dancers, it's not easy. Opportunists would want to give us work because we are females.
This is the point that I need us to talk about.
And it's
because
really not
Because I
nice.
Think it is even still happening.
It's still, now I'm telling you, I still get that until today. It's so, so sickening. It's so bad.
Talk to us about this, please.
And I'm not going to be sorry about it.
No, you can't. Yes.
Respectful. not every man or not every woman, ah, this is crazy, I'm a woman and a man can be able to say hello, what's up. You can have a talent and somebody wouldn't be able to give you work just because they want to sleep with you.
True.
Or they want to trick a boss so that they can be able to get to the girls. So that was a challenge being very young in the industry, and when people give us work, they expect to have something in return. But because we were God, we're still God-driven. You know, when you have God, you can be able to, obstacles, you can be able to maneuver. So being females was not so easy, and having young gentlemen then, they managed to overcome so many things without damaging us. That's why I'm still standing. If you go to Nairobi, Kenya, Tanzania, you can never get any negative vibe about me or anybody who says, I've ever done this with this person.
True.
Because of the foundation that we set in Uganda. And also just being blessed to have people that were mature enough to be able to guide us, like the Baby Cools, the Chameleons, the Julianas. Because they were a bit older, so when they give us work, like females, they sit us down and say, don't be maneuvered, don't be lied to. There's alcohol. There are so many things. You can get into addiction.
Exactly.
Even at a very young age, because imagine you're always in bars. So if you're
hanging with these people that are doing these things, so by virtue of that fact, you end up doing
it. It can
the
even
same.
Get to your head. Leave alone somebody wanting to take advantage.
Yes.
You yourself, you can get lost if you're really not driven. If you don't have the right principles, why you got into dance? I got into dance because I was looking for a better future.
Okay.
A short brief. I lost my father when I was very young, so I had to look for a way out to be in school and not get married. So when I got into Eclipse, I knew I wanted school and a better future.
Okay.
So even when I was in clubs and everything and somebody comes to me, I had my principles that I can be in a place where already we're being judged. Judging us, someone will say, oh, yo, that one slept with everything. Or you're not respected as a woman just because you're in bikinis. Not bikinis, really. Tumboka.
So
like, you know how we are always sexual. Another thing that that has been there until today, people sexualize dance.
That was my next part. I also want us to talk about that. But before we go to how people sexualize dance.
Yes.
The young... Today,
yes,
everyone is trying to go into entertainment.
Yes.
Be a dancer, be a content creator,
yes.
Sing.
Yes.
But the pressure is too much.
Too much.
You see, the other time there was no internet, there was no social media.
Yes.
So you could I feel like the pressure wasn't as much. But right now someone opens their Instagram, they look at Shakira, who has already made it, who has been in this for 23 years, they're like, I need to get this. Even in 2 years, I need to get this.
And that's
and
the
they
problem.
Do the unthinkable. I need you to talk.
And it's really, really true. I'm just gonna talk to somebody who sees my outside success because I'm a success story.
Definitely.
There are many people who were doing this, and because of not having the principles or just knowing what they want in the showbiz, they ended up getting pregnant. Others are dead. Others got this sexual transmitted diseases, you know. So I would say, first of all, nothing comes easy, you know. Even a child, when you're pregnant, you don't give birth to a child that will just go to uni.
Okay.
So there's some steps that you're supposed to take. Have God in your life. Know why you're dancing. I'm dancing for a purpose. You can see somebody who wants to dance because Beyonce is dancing.
Oh.
So somebody will come with the intention of, I just want to be like Beyonce.
Yes.
And you can never be anybody else. Be yourself, man. You know?
Exactly.
Know yourself. Know why you're doing something. Know why you're entertainment. When you know your why and you know your purpose, why you're doing it, it's going to be very easy for you to maneuver.
Exactly.
With all the challenges, because they will be there. Not only in entertainment, even in the... other businesses,
exactly,
you know.
Sure.
It's how you maneuver through
because
them.
Because the public already has this perception. Of you. So if you give into it, then you're letting the public win, really.
Yes, you're supposed to respect yourself. Nobody's gonna respect you if you don't respect yourself, because already we are being judged. Me, until today, it's unfortunate. Even my family judges me.
No.
I'm never supported, by the way.
No.
I've done it 23 years strong. I'm a Muslim. So, you know, take a kakatambara. But anyway,
girl, let's talk about this. I don't want to put myself in your shoes,
yes.
but imagine mm-hmm. you're doing this, you're doing dance,
mm-hmm.
and the public is already has a perception
judging
of you,
and you have a family,
and the family is not supporting you. How did you do this?
Let me tell you, if you go to my socials, maybe 3 days ago, I put a long post that was triggered by a family member. Until today, I'm not celebrated with what I've done for myself. Being a girl or being a woman in an industry, you know it. It's not easy. But having people from home, just because of, I love religion.
Yes.
I love religion. I'm not saying I'm not. I know faith is a personal thing.
Mm.
But there's a way we take the teachings too seriously that we are damaging or blocking blessings that God has given us. Everybody's here for a reason and purpose. There's somebody who's supposed to be a doctor. There's somebody who's supposed to be, I believe we can all be lawyers.
Yeah.
So I believe that God gave everybody a God-given talent. Just have to find out what you're doing. So for family members, or I would talk to mothers and fathers, because those are the key people in anybody's life.
True.
Support your children. Find out what your child loves. Your child would love football, and you want the child to be a doctor.
Mm.
And yet, if you nurture the footballer, they are celebrated right now. Let's talk about entertainment. Us in entertainment are living a life.
Mm.
I'm happy what I'm doing, and I'm getting paid. I don't wake up saying, oh, I have to go to job at 8. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. And you find so many people. I'm going to use the higher titles that we see as society,
okay.
lawyer, doctor, and everything. Some of those people are addicts of alcohol, which they think we are.
You know, there are the three jobs
yeah.
that we grew up, they are telling, if you don't become a lawyer, you become a doctor or an engineer.
Yeah.
That's it, period.
And yes, and yet these guys, you can find somebody who really didn't want to be a doctor, and they're busy, you know, doing surgery.
Exactly.
It damages, it makes them crazy, and they keep drinking. But they wouldn't know what the torture is behind somebody you want
because
your child to do.
Your son is putting on the white coat.
Yeah, so you're so happy because this is a doctor, but your child is damaging her or himself with the addiction that they think is in entertainment.
Mm.
I wouldn't deny it's there.
It's exactly,
everywhere.
Yes.
So you have to pick and say, do I wanna lose myself while I'm working, or do I wanna balance it up? I would say there's something that you cope. Everybody copes with something in life. You can cope with coffee every day.
Exactly.
That's an addiction. You can cope with water every day. That's an addiction.
Oh my God.
You can cope with praying. That's an addiction. It can be either a good addiction or a bad addiction.
I'm still thinking about it. So sorry about, you know,
yeah,
not getting the support.
Yes.
Now, moving to you, what you have achieved.
Yes.
Let's celebrate you.
Oh my God.
Want to celebrate you? That is their problem.
I celebrate myself because
yes.
it hasn't been easy.
Exactly.
Yes.
Your achievements.
My achievements.
What you're doing now.
Yes.
Please talk to us about my achievements.
So through dance, I managed to go to a place called Kenya and I found myself working with beautiful people.
Okay.
Those are the legends.
Right.
I'm working with Nameless right now, so I'm going to be, shout out to Nameless and Wahoo. So as you see me here through dance,
okay.
My growth went into production management.
Oh,
I do
wow.
production management for them. I do the video producing for them.
Mm-hmm.
I do
oh,
choreography
wow.
for them.
Mm.
I do stuff that are related with social media.
Mm-hmm. Management.
Not even
and
management,
promotion.
Really,
mm.
but the socials like TikTok, managing the
promotion.
Yeah,
okay.
like because you know nowadays we're using TikTok as a way
exactly,
of pushing music.
Mm.
So in case of anything, they want to, the who and who, I'm the one who does that. And a bit of assistance here and there.
Okay.
I'd call myself a family member because they have managed to teach me everything and also connect me to different brands like Safaricom.
Right.
I happen to work for Safaricom. It's a celebrated
thing
about Safaricom.
Mm, yeah.
I managed to work with different, many artists, and I've traveled around Nairobi, Kenya at large,
okay.
worked with the artists that are just coming up
right.
and the artists that are up.
Mm.
Artists that are up, I'll talk about Wire. Those are my people.
Mm-hmm.
Jua Kali. I've worked with... a social, the KTN, there's a CEO called Charles.
Okay.
He managed to give us some work. How can I forget the person that made Eclipse what it is? Because without Leaky or Dara, so we went to Nairobi. Shout out to Leaky. I'm so sorry, I forgot about you. So we went to Nairobi, and my boss managed to have a good relationship with somebody called Leaky. So Leaky was in entertainment. I would miss pageants,
okay.
like all pageants
yes,
or something.
Yeah.
So he managed to connect us from different places to different clients and all that. Why am I?
Where is Eclipse now?
Talk about it. Eclipse, some of the members are now working for Swans. I talked about
Julius.
And then there's a production lead manager who is called Kasozi Ivan.
I think I've heard of him.
Also, there's somebody, an IT guru, that's Andrew Mogisha. And then in Nairobi, I'm still with my sister. So Eclipse, we were younger, and them, they were a bit older.
Okay.
So when we went after a success, of course, Julius was so... I always say, alaba wala nyo.
The vision was,
Oh my goodness, he had a vision. He was already in Nairobi, but he was already planning on comeback. Because you might as well kuangalia watari
wo. Yeah, definitely.
So you go pick something from a different place. That's
okay.
why we travel and network and learn.
Yes.
So he managed to get a few, he managed to get the growth. I'll call it growth.
Yes.
And brought it back to Kampala, and he started doing magazines, brought up buzz events, went into production, and now we are at Swans. And other guys, unfortunately, we have lost people in the group.
Yeah.
Others are mothers right
are
now.
Are you married? Are you there yet?
That is a bit private. It is a private tea.
It cannot grow. You have to give us some tea. You have to give us some tea. Eh? Do we have Mini Shakira?
Mini Shakira?
Yeah.
Not really.
Do we have Shakira's bestie?
Yes, maybe.
You
know, nowadays, they say, when you're here and somebody's in a different world, there's somebody.
Which world is it? Which world? He's in Europe.
Yes.
As long as he's there, me, I do not care if he's there. That
he's
means,
there.
You know.
Yeah,
he's
been a good support as well,
okay.
So I appreciate that.
How do you stay in shape? Because you see,
oh my God.
23 years, and you have to ensure you stay strong, you stay fit to perform and do these dances.
Of course.
How do you do it?
I call dance a fitness lifestyle.
Okay.
I don't need to go to gym.
Oh, really?
Of course. Dance
so these people that are killing themselves with...
Let me tell you, of course, if you want to have a bit of muscle and everything, you can still achieve it home. If you have the money, you can still go out.
Yeah.
But when you're dancing, it's a healthy lifestyle.
Mm.
So dance has managed to keep me healthy
because
I love it and everything.
Yeah.
And also watch what you eat, man. As you grow, as females, your body changes.
Yeah.
So if you don't watch what you eat, you end up looking old.
Vagarante.
When I say what you eat, no mwenge guri or more drinking, everything, because what you put in is what comes out.
Oh, okay.
There's no way you can be looking bad and you're saying, Nina Chengora. Oshegera. So it starts from within so that it comes out.
All right.
Take care of yourself. Invest in yourself. You only have one body and one life. So if you don't invest in yourself, you can't borrow. I can't come today and kugamba. So kumpeka kumbidi gencha nina jendaga.
So
just take care of yourself and so dance keeps me fit generally.
As we are winding up the interview, someone who is watching, mostly for me right now this week, we are talking to the ladies.
Yes.
What is that important trait a dancer should have?
Important
trait. That one trait a dancer should have.
I would say again, I don't know if it's gonna be cliche.
Mm.
I feel like respect is underrated.
Oh, okay.
It has. You can be able to. Amanyinga bakuwa title no bango sebolo kujuwabu.
Your subsidiary. Yes.
It's how you understand. I would put everything in respect, because with respect, people can respect you and you can be able to grow from one
area
to the
other. Okay.
When you don't do that, respect also includes having just God. panze katonda kankubuli awatali katonda nange lero sali to say oh anonga ya Allah segera awatali katonda even when I'm battling my demons, my family and just the world itself, when I just cover myself and just say, oh God, just take over, go ahead of me, you get, let me meet people that are of you and of importance. When you speak things of God, and also be kind, man. You can't expect for you to have a beautiful life or a success. Nga gwoli movie. Tosobola, man.
You see them on Twitter dragging each other left, right,
center. So I believe what you put out there is what you receive in return.
You're in Uganda. Are you working on a project?
So I was coming there. I just want to give a big, huge shout out to Urban TV and also Ibra.
All right.
So I came, of course, I've been doing this for 23 years.
Yeah.
And I feel it's about time because of social media platform. I've worked for 23 years and on socials, nobody will take you seriously when your socials are not high there.
Oh, yeah, if you don't
have
the numbers.
A brand would come to you because they're getting something out of you. It's the value.
Mm.
And when we started, of course, we didn't have the social platform.
Yeah. Yeah.
And when the socials came, we were already in a space where we were working.
Okay.
Everything. So you are pushing.
So now socials
has come and I'm like, I need to come back, reintroduce myself to the Ugandan industry.
Oh.
Because I am celebrating Uganda globally.
Exactly.
So I came for a media tour and you're the first people to interview. And I am so grateful to Urban TV.
All right.
Such platforms are the platforms that help people, help people that don't have voices. When I started off, my background is not that great, you know. I come not from a very wealthy family. But just because of people believing in me, I got here. Mm. And just because also Urban believed in me, somebody who is out there, katuo mwana aliawa today, mama wabona wabona gambo mwana yabachi, there are opportunities that you can make yourself because God has given you.
Where can they find you?
We're on talking to people on socials. Yeah. I'm called Shakira's Brand.
Shakira's Brand.
On Instagram, Nasari Shakira. On Facebook, Nasari Shakira. On YouTube, and Shakira's Brand on TikTok.
Okay, yeah, because I know they would want to, you know, DM
Yes, you can DM me. Mm. I'm here to be the voice of everybody. I want to help. I've already done amazing things when I came here. I'm meeting up with comedians that I'm helping. I'm already helping hospitality because I've learned a lot of stuff. If I'm doing management and I'm in producing, it means there's something that I can be able to bring
to
back
put out
home.
There, yes.
So before I come back home, like Nkomi Odala, I needed to set the foundation and say, Zevampita Shakira, Nakola Chino Nachino, Atene Yagala Nichenkolanche Yagaza.
My girl, I'm telling you, thank you so much for stopping
by. Thank you so much.
And
as well,
we'll be looking out for your work, definitely.
Yes.
If you need anything, you know where
to
find
us. Oh my God. You've already done
so much.
Let me say, you've already done it all because this is a seed to millions of people.
Yes.
And I believe people can be able to find it on YouTube streaming, right?
Definitely.
Yeah.
We are live on Facebook.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, guys, for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. Tomorrow is Women's Day. We're going to be having Pinky on the show, and we'll be talking to her, so make sure you watch out for that.
Yes.
I wish you a great Women's Day.
Happy great Women's Day. Let's celebrate women. Let's
always
respect
now
women
and always. Thank you so much, and peace out.
Yeah, peace out. Love you.